Now the question is, can it ever work in the league? Because I was talking about it yesterday, and I felt like this doesn't look like something that can work in the league in Nigeria. But hey, who am I to say? What do you think about it?
Well, to start with, the video assistant referee issue is a different thing. It's bringing technology into what is ordinarily have to be human. It's a new situation in football. In 2014, what was used was just to know whether a ball crossed the goal line or not. But it has now moved to a situation whereby it now assists referee in making certain decisions, which ordinarily, in the normal course of play, they are supposed to take certain decisions within split second.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's stand. But now, they now have to be prompted. If there is an infringement, they have to be prompted by people in the control room to say, no, something has happened. One of the instances is that of Nigeria-Netherlands match. When the game had already even resumed, game was already on, when the center referee was informed that there has been an incident which was a possible penalty kick. And in most cases, when the VAR caused the attention of the referee, in most cases, the referee always agree with whatever he has been informed by the VAR. Mm. Right? Because that time, the ball actually touched the Nigerian defender's hand.
Mm.
And it was not just given, a penalty kick was not just awarded, it was also cautioned. But you now ask yourself, what happened in the Nigeria-Argentina match when a similar situation happened and the VAR, the video assistant referee, informed the central referee that there has been a handball. And the referee went to check the monitor and actually saw that ball touched the Argentine players first on the shoulder, then on the hand.
Palm, yeah.
But he used his discretion to say that, okay, it was ball to hand and not hand to ball. Because the hand was very close to the body.
Mm.
So that's where I have my issues with video assistant referee. And then in Nigeria, where we find it difficult to actually televise matches.
True.
How will you be able to have cameras dedicated just for VAR?
Mm.
It's a very difficult situation here in Nigeria. Except maybe we talk of another VAR, which is voodoo assistant referee, where you now have to go and consult
the oracle
to say, okay, did this thing happen or it didn't happen?
Mm.
Except that even in Africa now, it's only Morocco that's the first African country to implement it in its domestic, because they have the resources.
True.
Every stadium may have been equipped with enough cameras to cover the match and also for the video assistant referee operators.
Mm.
Otherwise, in Nigeria, that would be a tall order. When even clubs resist the effort to bring television cameras to come and watch, to come and cover their games, they resist it. In other clan, people even want their matches to be shown. Where your stars are showcased to the global audience.
Mm-hmm.
That's also where you make your money from television rights.
Right.
But here, it's just an area we just don't want to go into.
Mm. That's a sad case for the Nigerian professional football league. Talking about the VAR, it looks like an impossible mission, but hey, you never can tell what can happen with the administration of football in Nigeria. It might be one of the plans of the NFF and the football body to bring the VAR down to Nigeria.